this is the Electrom Instruments iTIG 3. Before we get started, we're going to cover the first things you see when you unpack your iTIG 3. You have the red start-stop button. We have a silver dial here to turn the voltage up if you're doing a manual type of test. We have two USB ports for extracting data. We have a foot switch jack, an accessory port, and a resistance and low voltage measurement port that's used for the non-automatic version, so the B and C model, for example. This is the D model, so we have six high voltage output leads and a ground lead. Take the ground lead and connect it to the frame, to phase one, to phase two, to phase three. Now that we're hooked up to our test load, we can go ahead and enter in the required information in the instrument. So you click start. We're now going to work our way from left to right in the bottom. We're actually now at the last tab here, the test summary screen. We're going to enter in the test description. I like to enter in something saying what we're testing on, let's say a stator as opposed to an assembled motor or a rotor, for example. You can use this drop-down menu to select from a list of predefined test stages. Let's pick an incoming used in this case. Operator information. Next step, go to the setup screen. We have our high pot and surge test voltage formulas. The test stage we selected defines it to 2 times the operating voltage plus 1000. If you don't like the final test voltage, you can click the white field and enter in your preferred test voltage, or you can use the drop-down menu and select a different test stage if you'd like to do so. If I click this again, it will correct the formula back to our original state. You can enter in the humidity. Let's say 56%, it will stick that number in the report. You can also enter in the winding temperature, let's say 25 degrees on a nice hot summer day. The instrument will automatically correct the winding resistance and insulation resistance. Next step, auto mode and limit setup. Everything that's green on the left side here is included in the fully automated test set. This includes capacitance, inductance, and impedance, winding resistance, insulation resistance, DC high pot, surge test, and for good measure, let's include partial discharge as well. We can change the mega ohm test voltage, in this case 500 volts for a low voltage motor. We can select a test profile. We're going to do a 1 minute DAR in this case. If it was a bigger machine or you had certain requirements, you could pick a PI, for example, including DAR. Similar for the DC high pots, we're going to do a 1 minute, 1 point test, but you have the option of doing a 5 point step test, 10 point step test, you could do a ramp test, or you can define your own test sets. Click save motor test configuration. This is now stored, so next time you test this motor, no setup required. Exit setup. Make sure it's safe to start testing on the motor. Click start full auto test and press the red button. We will start with the inductance, impedance, and capacitance measurements. This is not a pass-fail type of measurement, so we will move on to winding resistance here shortly. For winding resistance, we measure the resistance in phase 1, 2, and 3 and calculate the max delta R. We passed that measurement, so we're now on to our insulation resistance test. The instrument automatically brings the voltage up to our predefined 500 volts. It will now sit there for 1 minute and it will calculate the DAR at the end. If we exceed the predefined 5 mega ohm min value, we're going to move on to the DC high pot test. And we got a DAR of 2.12 and we exceeded the minimum requirement. So we're now on to our high pot. The instrument brings up the voltage to 1920 automatically. And we're now going to sit here for 1 minute and measure the leakage current. After a full minute, the instrument will automatically shut off the test, discharge the winding, and move on to the surge test. We're now doing surge in phase one, PD in phase one, surge phase two, PD phase two. I'm not keeping up with the instrument, and we are done with the test in phase three as well. If you click the last button here again, we're back to our test summary screen. All pass,